And so that is what I see in the new development paradigm. A very key role will be played by science and technology, by education, because it will be linked to whatever comparative advantage then comes to us by nature of our physical positioning, by nature of the markets, by nature of human capital, by nature of government investment, all those other variables will have to be joined by this emphasis on science and technology, which will position that particular country in a competitive stance in a global, highly global economic situation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for that very valuable and informative keynote address. And we are truly grateful for your presence here today. And we are also thankful for the contribution of a number of other eminent personalities. And to express our appreciation on behalf of KDU, I would now like to invite our Vice Chancellor, Major General Milinda Piris, to present tokens of appreciation. Chief Guest, Dr. Sarath, Amunugama. As I have mentioned before, KDU-IRC is a massive event which required a great deal of effort and teamwork. There are many who joined hands with utmost commitment to make this conference a success. It is important to acknowledge all effort taken in order to make this event. This invitation is extended to Dr. Namali Sirisoma, the conference chair of KDU-IRC 2014, to deliver the vote of thanks.
The chief guest, Dr. Sarath Amunugama, the commanders of three forces, distinguished invitees, conference delegates, ladies and gentlemen. I consider it's a great privilege to be delivering the vote of thanks at the inaugural ceremony of KDU International Research Conference 2014. It is extremely valuable to organize conferences in this nature to see the expanding research and innovation in a time that everyone expects the entire world in a few-inch touch screen. The conferences of multidisciplinary research environment are rare to find due to the nature of difficulties in organizing. However, we are lucky to organize this conference today in KDU with six disciplines because KDU is blessed with all the capabilities in this university. As the conference chair, I would like to first express my sincere thanks to our chief guest and the keynote speaker, Dr. Sarath Amunugama, the Senior Minister of International Monetary Cooperation and Deputy Minister of Finance and Planning, for gracing this occasion and delivering the keynote address, which was both illuminating and thought-provoking. Sir, thank you for accepting our kind invitation and sharing your valuable thoughts with us. Even though it's not here, it's my duty to thank the Secretary of Ministry of Defense and Urban and Development, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksha, for his guidance and assistance given us during these conference arrangements. The support and the guidance as the Chairman of Board of Management of KDU, he has extended to KDU, and it is indeed immeasurable. I would also like to extend our thanks to secretaries, the additional secretaries of ministries, members of diplomatic corps, and the commanders of three forces, Sri Lanka Army, Navy, and Air Force, and their esteemed presence in our research conference. We are truly honored to have you all with us today to witness the inauguration of KDU-IRC 2014. We owe a word of thanks to high-ranking officers from neighboring countries, foreign scholars, dignitaries, and eminent expertise who have come here today all the way to participate in the KDU Research Conference. The chairperson of the University Grants Commission and the vice chancellors of other state universities have been given the highest moral support for the KDU conference. I also thank distinguished senior academics and in national universities, high officials of the government, and professionals in diverse fields and expertise for reviewing our papers, delivering speeches in this conference, chairing sessions, and presenting valuable academic papers in this conference. Organizing a gigantic task like this would be impossible without a proper leadership and teamwork. Therefore, I would like to express my sincere thanks to our Vice Chancellor, Major General Milind Pires, for his excellent leadership during this exercise, conceptualization, planning, and execution of the conference. And the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Defense and Administration, Brigadier Lal Gunasekara, for the invaluable contribution as the steering committee president that ensured the smooth execution of this event, and the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academics, Senior Professor Susirith Mendis, for his guidance during the finalizing papers. Furthermore, I wish to acknowledge the services rendered by the deans of all the faculties, the heads of organizing committees and their teams, faculty representatives, the adjutant, CEO administration, registrar, bursar, and all the academic and administrative staff members. Also, I would like to sincerely thank all the others who supported us but could not mention by name during this organizing event. I should also express a very special word of thanks to our sponsors, mainly Melvire Rolling Private Limited and Polytechnologies Corporation China and Bank of Ceylon, for their generosity in giving us the financial assistance to organize this event today in such a grand level. Let me also thank members of the media who are covering this international conference, thereby helping the process of dissemination of knowledge. In addition, I would like to thank the conference secretaries, Ms. Thilini Migaswate and Ms. Dilani Pereira, for their tiresome work all over the time with the secretariat. I would like to express my sincere thanks to the dean and the assistant registrar and his staff of the Faculty of Management, Social Sciences and Humanities for assisting me during this organizing work. And any conferences cannot succeed without the participation of researchers. When we advertised this research, we received 313 abstracts from researchers, academia, and experts from national and private universities in this country. After the double-blind peer review, we accepted 266 abstracts to submit full papers in this conference. And by the end of the deadline of the full paper submission, we received 200 full papers, which was totally unexpected, and we had to stop receiving papers because of the increased number, disappointing some of the authors who sent their abstracts. And we double-blind peer-reviewed those papers again and selected 185 papers to be presented in this conference today as oral and poster presentation. On behalf of KDU, I would like to thank all the authors who submitted papers and abstracts in this conference. And I would like to request them to improve their research knowledge, writing skills, and other research habits to submit more advanced papers in the future. Because once your paper is submitted in our proceedings or any other journals, the entire world can access your publications, and they will use your findings and recommendations in other research projects for the betterment of this world. So I wish to like to take this opportunity to wish all the best to these speakers, and then I wish they will expand their developmental horizons in their research knowledge during these 2 days, and will submit more advanced papers in our research conference 2015. Enjoy your time here and our hospitality. Thank you.
Thank you. With that, we come to the closure of the inauguration ceremony of 7th International Research Conference of General Sir John Kothalawala Defence University. This is a very special occasion for us here in KDU, and we would certainly like to preserve the moment. And therefore, I would like to invite following distinguished invitees to retain here for a few more minutes for the conference photographs. Our chief guest, all representatives from diplomatic missions, Triforces commanders, Chairman UGC, Mrs. Jayaradna and Mrs. Mahesh Mahinda Salia, Vice Chancellor, Deputy Vice Chancellors, and the Deans of KDU, all Vice Chancellors from other universities, Chair and Presenters from Defence Plenary Session and Technical Sessions, all foreign dignitaries, Conference Chair. Before breaking for refreshments, we are now presenting tokens of appreciation for another set of valuable stakeholders.